I always do the same thing. I hit live button, I kind of check things out, and then I do this little spin. Of course, it's important that all my streams are pretty much exactly the same every time, because I wouldn't want to have to come up with something new. Ugh. Anyway, welcome to the Friday stream. This glass seems like it's taller than the other glasses I usually use, maybe even huger. It's actually not. It's the same size. It's a little narrower in this dimension here, in the diameter. It's the same amount of Diet Coke pretty much as I normally have. So please, no cards and letters. I don't need that. Oh, that's good. Oh, hi, Diet Coke. Cheers. Ooh, oh, it's condensation. And that little, you know, that little glow from my Himalayan salt lamp really, I think it really adds something to the flavor. So anyway, if you haven't been to the stream before, what is wrong with you? Why? No, that's not what I was thinking. What I was going to say is this, my stream is the following. Roughly an hour of Microsoft Flight Simulator content. We fly around. I have a couple of cities in mind, but if somebody wants me to fly over their hometown and comes into chat and says, fly over my hometown, I'll probably do it. We try to crash into buildings sometimes. The second half, I take a short break, and the second half of my stream is me playing live music. You're well aware of this. Hurricane. All right, let's find the hurricane. Let's see if we'll find it on the map. Okay, fine. Hurricane, it is. We'll be able to see it on the map. Hold on a second. If the hurricane is no fun, first of all, you can see it right here. It's a tight storm. You can see, okay, yeah, I'm just making sure I'm on the right thing. You know, when you get up close, it's probably already dissipating because it's hit the Yucatan Peninsula. But you can see it might be moving off the peninsula, and it will gain. This is warm water here, so it'll gain energy again. It's the warm water. Oh, by the way, I see Hobie Gal is off in Cuba. Anything going on in Cuba? I don't know if she's watching my stream though. All right, so I guess if we wanted to do it, first of all, we're going to pick a plane that I mentioned has weather radar. And I was going to, you know, perfect any of these shorts have good quality weather radar. We'll do the pink. You know, while we're doing it, we'll do the only fun livery. Actually, the clownfish is pretty fun. We'll do clownfish today. They're both good. But we'll start. See, I'm trying to figure out where it's going to be. I think it's going to be right here. And we can start in the air. So this is a custom airborne 5,000 foot departure. And it's either going to be fun and interesting, or we'll go back to my primary idea of finishing up the cities from the update, the recent update, which is the ones we haven't been to are Annapolis and Southampton, New York. But this could be interesting. Again, it's real-time weather, so I don't know exactly how accurate. I've flown into a couple of real-time storms before. It was kind of interesting. It was definitely interesting. And you can't really see what's going on from that view that we just had, but you can see a lot more from your weather radar, hopefully. I don't know if it's going to be tight enough to show an actual eye, a storm eye activity. As I mentioned before yesterday, we were talking about this. You can fly through a storm. If you can find the eye, you'll suddenly fly through the eye and it'll be sunny. And you'll be able to see all the way down to the ocean, say. And then you fly through the other side of the eye. And it's like you can't see shit anymore. But it's cool. And we can try to do that a couple times. But it all depends on whether the storm really has that at this point. Probably yesterday would have been better. There's a mod you can get that where you can kind of plant storms. You know, you can specify a storm and then you can fly through it. But I don't have that mod. 50s? Yeah, it's a medium. That's not so much. Okay. Yeah, well, I'm sure that's one of the major features. The famous Naval Academy in Annapolis has a really, really cool architecture by a very famous architect, I think, and it has those kind of sail. We'll see it. We'll check it out. No, I think we'll have time. I want to do the full hour of Microsoft, like, and we're getting started. And then I want to play my lounge act for an hour. All right. It's thinking. It's kind of loading. It's... We're flying through clouds, which I expected. I see Vic back there. Victor. Okay, so what I want to do is get down here. Okay, so you can see on that lower right thing, pink is the, that pink color is the heart, the highest end winds. We probably want to ascend a bit. We're about 5,000 feet. Yeah, visibility is not the issue. The issue is looking at the weather radar. We could probably get above it. Well, if we were in a jet, we could get above it. But this plane can't because its ceiling is 15,000 feet, which is probably below the level of the clouds. But what I'm doing is looking at this right thing. See that brightly colored weather radar? That's showing up to 60 miles out in front of us. And what I'm trying to do is look to see if there's something in front of us that might show an eye. So basically, we're heading north from the Yucatan Peninsula. Let me see if I can adjust the radar range. Okay, so that's too much. So I'm trying to see if there is some kind of pattern here, and it kind of depends on where we're looking. Do I have autopilot on? Oh, I do. All right. Wondering what's going on there. I have my autopilot on. Couldn't turn. I'm trying to get to the worst of the weather, which is pink on this. I'm thinking that might be the eye. Somebody's flying on the ground. I think some of those people over there might have found it. And that might not be the eye. Come to think of it. Doesn't look like an eye from here. A little bumpy, but nothing major. There's a bunch of people back there. There's a lot of people flying around in here. But again, if you can't do something fun like find the eye, then there's not much to it. And I'm not saying anything that looks like a nice circular structure surrounded by clouds. But it could be hard to find it in the weather radar because the weather radar has a limited view. It has a limited view out. It effectively, it does get blocked by enough rain. But I think maybe it's over here. I'm gonna go see if maybe we're closer to where Victor is. I'm looking at the weather radar and it's showing that in a second we should be breaking out into some clear areas. Yeah, I think you might have. I'm gonna head to kind of where you are. That looks like it on the weather radar, because if you can see, yeah, it looks like in every direction you're surrounded by clouds and you're in the eye. But if you can see, you know, if you can see kind of clear air in one direction, then you're just on the edge of the storm. But we'll see in a second. I think this might be the eye. A lot of people have this idea. We won't be able to see them, but there's a million other planes flying around this particular area. Or is that the eye straight ahead? Oh, see that little thing looks like a hole there. In the clouds. That's where we're gonna go. Okay, so we're at heading 160. I might set the autopilot for 160. And then we'll do autopilot back on. Turn that on. Okay, so you can see here, this is, I don't know, is this the eye there? It's kind of not, it's kind of hard to tell, but you can see there's, you can see the sea down there below, and then there's clouds all around in all directions, but it's not really circular. So I don't know for sure. This could be it. It's hard. Again, once it's in this formation, it's not going to be a very nice circle. It'll just be kind of an area where there's a gap, like this. Oh, yeah. Well, you're surrounded. I kind of am, too. Okay, let me see where you are. Okay, can I go to left here? Make this a left turn. What? You're low, too. Yeah, maybe this is the eye around here, right off the coast. Let's come around a little more left. Let's see, 138. But yeah, you can kind of see that there is large, large thunder clouds going quite a ways up all around this area here. So I'm guessing this is the eye. It's roughly the center point, but you can see all around that pink in the radar there indicates extreme weather activity ahead. Directly ahead, that you can see those clouds in front. That's extreme weather activity. That's what it looks like, and that's what it looks like on the weather radar. Again, having that separate weather radar is really key for any kind of weather based activities. If you want to go into a storm, because yeah, you don't get good visibility. You know, obviously you can see where you are on the ground, relative to the ground, but what's going on in the air, you need the your weather radar. But yeah, you can see the ocean, a lot of white caps because it's all roiled up. They do a lot of really good detailing work, like because the ocean's on a storm, it's a little more white cappy than normal, I think. There's high winds in the area. And then you can see we're coming on to the coast. Now we're heading south. Yeah, we're kind of coming onto the coast of the Yucatan Peninsula. I can switch this to the ground radar, which is kind of cool. Actually, I have ground maps, so I don't really need that. You can see on my GPS, it's showing. It's showing that we're coming onto the land there. That's the coast right there. Well, I do like it's kind of fun to fly in a storm, but as you know, my meat and potatoes is sightseeing of cities. I mean, I don't like to, you know, compartmentalize myself or anything. And again, they've done a good people complain about the clouds in Microsoft Flight Sim, but I think they're good. They're certainly the best from any previous flight sims. You really get that feeling of flying through fluffy clouds in a plane. Oh, you know the other thing I figured out how to do I want to do today? There's a bunch of stuff I want to do today. Yesterday I figured out, well, I didn't figure it out, but at least I tried it again and it seemed to work. How to fly through fireworks. I wasn't streaming during 4th of July fireworks time. I was streaming in the mornings, you know. So it's not fireworks time. But you could set the clock, and I tried this before and it didn't work. So it's like more like interesting thing. And we can see it in the map there, that there's like a breakup of this next part, I think, to the west is the edge of the storm. All right, so we'll be flying out the edge. We're going to go a little west, a little to the left here. Flying basically southeast. So there's two things I want to accomplish, and this is only one of them. This wasn't one of them. One of them, I want to check out the new cities, And the other thing is, I want to take you guys on a little trip through the fireworks by advancing the time to 10 p.m. And we'll go to New York. That's where I was, and it was really cool. You could fly right through them, right through. I was watching Peter do this the other day, or you know, and he got it to work. But he was like flying at a high level, and he didn't go right through the fireworks. I'm like, why did you do that? We have lightning going on here, by the way. Sometimes you can see the bright, those little flashes of lightning going on. But that's true. Anytime you're flying through pink, that pink level of weather, you can and should expect. I need some of this stuff going here. This, probably, for sure. Pitot's, just in case it gets cold up here. Is there anything interesting going on at ground level? But I do, okay, so there's, right, so there's two cities and then this fireworks thing. I didn't know there was fireworks in the game, and I was checking it out yesterday off after the stream, because I'm like, if I can't get it to happen, how did she change so quickly? She already, Mistress Mort already ended her strength. That's how she changed so quickly. Plus her hair changed again to not dyed. Okay, no, I was watching Mistress Mort, but I think I'm gonna watch. She's a repeat. She's going back to repeat. There's literally nobody I watch who's streaming. Normally, I like to watch a streamer while I'm streaming. It's just a thing. Well, she went live and then streamed, just said hi for about 30 minutes or less, I think. And then Bella's a rerun, but so is Mistress Mort. Mistress Mort went live from South Africa for about 30 minutes and then said, I'm tired, I'm going to bed, and because it's late there. And then she went to the rerun, or she went back to her rerun channel or whatever it is, and Bella's a rerun. I'm like, hey, what is this? Some kind of 4-day holiday for you guys? All right, look, guys, this is great content, and I love it, but I'm not doing it anymore, and you can't make me. Because I have other things I want to do, you know, with respect to my many, 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 many loyal viewers. It is kind of fun, especially in a small plane, to fly through the storms, because you get a lot of turbulence. I have turbulence turned on, too, you know. I mean, you could kind of turn it down. But this is what I want to show you guys, okay? It's something very specific. It's something I want to do. And we're going to do it. So for this to happen, we're going to fly. Let's fly an unusual little plane. Let's fly the Icon A5. I think that'll be good. And we'll take off on the water. We'll take off and land on water. There's a little water strip there. I'm going to show you how this works. I think this is cool. I had a great time doing this last night. And I'm like, well, I got to show my viewers this. Okay, where's my icon? I hope I didn't uninstall it. Right here. I love to fly it all the time. We got black. Kenmore. Black, obviously. Well, you know what? We're going to be flying at night, by the way. It's going to be pitch dark. Let's fly one of the lighter colors. So, and then we can select this 41,000 feet of water. But the most important thing is we have to advance the time. I actually have to check the date. I think it has to be July 4th. And is that the kind of closest I can get? Perfect. It doesn't start till 10:02, from what I can tell. So we have about 7 minutes to fly around, which is a long time when you're waiting for fireworks. I might be able to advance it a little bit more. Also, I have to check to make sure. Well, it eventually happened. I was kind of like thinking, well, it's not going to happen. But then it did. And it's really good. The fireworks go for like 10 minutes, so there's plenty of time to fly around in them. And as you'll see, there's some cool details. You can see the little rockets going up. And then, you know, these little white flashes going up, and then they explode. I'm surprised when you get close that they have some nice details for the fireworks. They don't have smoke. You know what I mean? That's the kind of that smoky thing that gets left behind when there's enough fireworks. But it's worth checking out. I would do it a couple times. I mean, at least once. Everybody's got to see at least once. So So, yeah, today will just be a regular stream, music stream later. I think I'm playing the Piano Lounge later. I don't remember if I played it yesterday. It doesn't matter. By the way, the Piano Lounge songs, and I'd like to mention this. I'm going to mention this more than once because these are the songs that I have completely memorized. All right, so here we got the map. Let's turn the map on. Map, there we go. What do we have here? Lights on. All these lights need to be on. Can't seem too well, but those are the lights. Okay, let's fly around. So we're gonna take off. A little bumpy on the water, but then when we lift off the water, it gets nice and smooth. And the interesting thing is that the fireworks weren't just over the whole area. There was like fireworks over certain parts of the city and fireworks over Central Park and blah, blah, blah. But of course, it would have been nice to do this on the actual, you know, day. But this, the other thing we get to do is to have a nice run of over, do a whole run of New York at night. Where's my internal lights? Where are those? Oh, here they are. Oh, it's avionics. Where's the light panel? There's a light panel somewhere. It's kind of back here. Can I turn off the lights from here? No. I don't want to get too high here, up out of the ground. We're going to be going real low. Oops. A little less power. A little less trim. A little less speed. There we go. Doing kind of a whole nighttime Manhattan run here. There's West Side Highway there. Freedom Tower, of course. All right, interior lights. Where would you be if you were interior lights? None of those are interior lights. There's avionics brightness, but that doesn't affect. Not really. Main battery. Maybe I can use my pilot light and figure out where the light switch is. I want to turn off the interior light, and I don't remember where it is. I think it's up here. Fuel valve. I don't see the lighting controls there. There's got to be a way to turn off lights. But I don't remember where the switch is. Yeah, so I've set the time, by the way. If you're flying around with me, but you have not set the time, specifically what I've done is, let's see if we can do this. Set the time. Okay, it's 9:58, so we have 4 minutes before 10:02. Oh, the other thing is, I don't know if it matters, but I set it to July 4th. Okay. I don't think that matters. But I don't know. So you set it to July 4th at some time right around as close as you can get to 10 p.m. That seems to work, although it doesn't actually trigger the fireworks until like 10:02. Hopefully that will happen this time. I think it probably does. And yeah, I did have to set the date. You can set the date as well as the time. So I went in here under weather. Right, and I set it to July 4th, 2024, 9, and it's 9:59. It's currently incrementing that time. So in 3 minutes, if I try it again, it'll say 10:02. And assuming that it works, it's totally worth it. This is going to be totally worth the, even if it's not, flying around New York at night is a vibe. Check out the East River over here. Got to be careful. These buildings are tall, and you can run into them, and you can, you know, you'll die. Really? You can see the eclipse. Wow. I would not surprise me. There we go. 10 o'clock. Look, folks. And it's going to go off for a good 10 minutes. Now, people were complaining that it's too low to the ground. And it's all around this area. It's all around. But not everywhere. So you can see there's a whole one here by where we took off from. And then you'll see in a second when we get closer to the to Central Park. There's a bunch going off in Central Park. But we're going to go flying through this. It would not surprise me if they have eclipses and other natural things like that, you know, worked out programmatically. But this is the first time I've been able to, I've done the fireworks, that I've seen the fireworks thing. And we're going to fly right through these things. It's pretty impressive. And as you can see, one thing you can't see that we, also you can't really hear it, which would be cool if like you could hear the popping sounds. But you can see when we get closer, you'll see little things come, little spots coming, little lights coming up from the ground. Those are the rockets that are being launched from ground-based mortars. You know, they're mortar shells. So you'll see them come up and explode. It's nice that they include that detail, but especially as you get closer, you can see all these little rockets being fired up, and they're being fired up from barges, I think, in this area. But it's quite spectacular to fly through these. I think, you know. It's like, wah. And the frame rate stays pretty good, but I've got a good GPU, so don't try this necessarily. But you see the buildings, you know, through the fireworks. And I don't know if that's be a, in the real world, whether it'd be a great idea to fly an airplane through active fireworks, given that you could be hit by one of those missile thingies. Where is Central Park? Okay, Central Park is up here. There's another kind of whole presentation in Central Park. So again, the only trick that you need to do is to set the time and date to be July 4th, roughly 10 p.m., just before 10 p.m. I tried it earlier in the day, by the way, this exact same thing, because I'd read this already on the forums, and it didn't work. So I think it was also only active after a certain time on the July 4th. So I tried it too early in the morning on July 4th, it didn't work. But it was after noon on July 4th, and they started working again. Or they started working for me. This is Central Park, Lois. It's not very well lit, so you can't tell, but you can see there's no buildings there. And yeah, they would have fireworks, and there's also lots of fireworks in Jersey. Jersey's to the west there. You can kind of see things exploding. All those little lights going up are rockets, all sorts of different colors. I think they, you know, nowadays they have those fireworks that when they explode, that they show that they explode not to a circular thing, but into a shape. You know what I mean? They're shape charges. And I think it'd be good, maybe good next year if they had not just these kind of circular burst ones, but the, you know, those shaped ones. And then they have the ones that burst, right? But then there's a secondary set of explosions, like each one of the things that exploded burst again, like a smaller explosion. You know what I mean? And then the ones that kind of burst late, so they tend to, because they're delayed, so the projectile is always going, already moving down when it explodes, and they kind of make the shower rather than a circle. There's all sorts of kind of things I think they could add. But the fact that they, you know, we got this content for free, as usual, thank you, to the Flight Simulator developers. It's really fun. It's really special. And again, what I haven't tried is some of the other cities, like Washington, D.C., I was watching other people fly through it, and yeah, there's fireworks going on right over all the good stuff in Washington, D.C., right over the National Mall. Is that Vic somewhere? I hear you, but I don't see you. You're around somewhere. It's amazing how the skies are filled with random other flight sim players these days. When I started playing, I rarely ever saw another human player. That was years ago. Excuse me. That was years ago, and now it's more popular, and it's a little easier to get into. But these are obviously these popular areas like Manhattan skyline. I do want to fly the Zeppelin over the Manhattan skyline, but you know, obviously that's a daytime thing. Oh, I don't think I know. I wouldn't know. I wouldn't know if that many people are watching my stream. No, as I'm saying, it's just we're all in the same shared server in the same place. You know, there's tens of thousands of players, so they're not all, we're not all here in New York. You can kind of barely see the silhouette of the plane against this against the fireworks, but it's great. And these go on for a while, like a real fireworks. I think they go on at least 20 minutes. Behind him, look behind. Yeah, that's what it looks like behind the plane there. It's a brilliant effect. I mean, well, it's fireworks. It is what it is. It's not perfect, but it's good. All right, let's come around again. We're not going to do fireworks again for a while, but I think I would like to do them again. As I say, it's always available. All you have to do is set your clock, your plane's clock to the correct time, to the appropriate time, and they'll happen. And apparently they happen everywhere. In any city larger than 50,000 people, which is a lot of cities, but these are what they call curated, meaning they specifically set up these fireworks displays in the place where they would be in that city. Look out the window and see stuff explode. That's my left window there. And even off in the distance, they look cool. But yeah, flying right through them is the way to go. So yeah, it's a new thing. Now I know if I feel like flying through fireworks, I know how to get that done. And again, just because we saw it over New York doesn't mean it wouldn't be cool to see over other cities as well. And it is all, basically any city. You should be able to do it at this time. But man, I was looking at, you know, some footage of Oakland, California from last night, from the 4th. And it kind of looks like this. There is so much, we have so much illegal fireworks, which means it basically just these things going off all over random parts of the city, not where they're supposed to go. It really kind of looks like this over Oakland. Not everywhere, but Oakland is really big into legal home fireworks for whatever reason. I don't know why. Don't want to say. All right. Madison Square Garden. But it's not square. It's a circle. Look at that. It's circular building. All right, I'll get over it. All right, I'm going to land, and then I'm going to go with the rest of my plan. Because, you know, this is beautiful, but I have some other things in mind. Specifically those two cities that I haven't seen that were updated. So what we're going to do now is we're going to come down here to the Hudson. This is the Hudson River here. On the west side of Manhattan is the Hudson. On the east side is the East River. This is the west side. Except for New Year's Eve, yeah. Well, there are legal fireworks, you know, that you go to in your community that are, you know, we all go to. And then there used to be what we called the safe and sane fireworks, which we did at home, and they were legal, but were pretty small, right? They didn't shoot anything up into the air. I mean, like, that exploded, you know, it was all from the ground, you know, fountains, right? Which is fine. I think they are safer. But the stuff that they're firing off are legal things, are mortar fireworks. So, in other words, they're things that you light and then they fire off into the sky and it explodes. Like, they're not fully as professional as these, but they're effectively like that. And they're usually bottle rockets, usually put in bottles. And they are super legal. And they have been forever. Interesting, James Madison. I wasn't sure it was James Madison, but I knew the fact that it's Madison Square, and then they built a round building. It wasn't named after the shape of the building at any point. It was there long before the building was there. So yeah, Madison Square Garden has nothing to do with the shape of the building, and it was Madison Square long before. But thank you for confirming that. All right, so we're gonna bring on. Okay, landing lights, please. Thank you. Thank you. You can barely see. There are lights, but they're pretty dim. All right, let's bring down some flaps so we can slow down a bit for landing on the water. Can't really tell how high up I am, but we'll figure it out. We're pretty close. Oh, that's water right there. I can feel it. All right, water rudder down so we can steer. Thank you. Yeah, now we can steer. And you can see the buildings of Manhattan, of downtown Manhattan right there. Yeah, well, It definitely gets crazy for New Year's here too, but I think July 4th is definitely the craziest it gets in terms of massive amounts of illegal fireworks going off. New Year's too, but no, yeah, for whatever reason, you know. Does this open? It does, but I have to go up here, right? Yeah. Cabin lighting. That's the cabin lighting? Okay, well now I know. I thought there was a door open up there. I was looking for cabin lighting, and I really didn't think it was that, but now I know. Okay. All right. I want to try, if anybody wants to follow along with me, there are these two cities, and one of them is Southampton, New York, and the other is Annapolis. So we've been asked already to go to Annapolis to check out the Naval Academy, and in order to ensure that we can do that, I'm going to do a little research here on the Google Maps, so... because I do kind of want to see that. Okay, so Annapolis, United States Naval Academy. It's right on the, what is that river? The Severn? Where is the, okay, interesting. Okay, all right. Oh, okay, where's the aeropuerto? We'll figure it out. Yeah, the thing about the real difference between New Year's and, you know, July 4th for fireworks is that July 4th is likely to be good weather. Okay, so Annapolis is, I think, let me look it up. Oh, I hate this feature. How close is that? Oh, it's a water runway. Oh, absolutely. Can you imagine? Okay, so there... We're going to take off in the same plane, water runway. Naval Academy is due west of this spot. So you see where it says Naval Academy and Annapolis. Perfect. Perfect. Wait, why are you blocking this? Same plane, right? Really? Yeah, well, no, they're definitely, I mean, they're definitely, you don't want to, I don't know. I've never been, like, messed up by fireworks, but yes. I mean, people are fascinated by the explosive capabilities. I mean, that's what they're there for. So, why here? Because As of last week, there was a city or world update or a city update that covered this northeast area. Now, I won't be able to tell what was changed because I don't think I've been here. Oh, nitrates. Interesting. That is a key ingredient of the kind of explosive that would be typically used. And plus, people can think of nitroglycerin as a sort of the classic nitrate. Okay, that's what we're in. We're in the icon. And we're going to be heading due east after we get off the water here. But for this, it's an afternoon run. It's the actual time of day. Plane comes right off the ground. Due west, right? Yeah, this way. So right away, there's some interesting things to see. Some kind of alien tower structures. I'm already happy. All right. For some reason, it sets the trim to something ridiculous every time. These trim things and those recommended trim areas are not so accurate on many planes, that's for sure. Whoops. Okay, less engine. I don't know what these are supposed to be. Oh, I bet this is a radio antenna or something. I don't know. All right, kids. What is this thing here? Stop. Okay, I'm right here at the map point where I can see what stuff is. So, right. Does it show these towers? I mean, it does kind of show these towers, but it doesn't say what they are. It just says Greenberry Point Light. Greenberry Point Conservation Area. And it shows these kind of towers on the map, but it does not say what they are. Maybe their cell phone or something? I don't know. I've never seen towers like that. Why would you need three of them so close together? I don't know. Okay, so technically... Right, I want to turn this way. This whole area here is the United States Naval Academy at Annapolis. They could be cell towers, but why would you need three of them so close together like that at the same height? I think it may be more of a military thing, you know, some kind of military something. But this whole area here, and it's a pretty big area here. Well, it goes all the way back to see where that bridge is in the back. This is the United States Naval Academy. We will be getting a nice close look of it at low level, but you can see there's you think that's a playing field, but that's where they kind of march and do show-offs, you know, show-off and things like that, I think. And then it looks like that's kind of a boathouse. I mean, it's naval. Lots of really cool-looking buildings. Where is the famous one, which is the church, I think, right? Maybe I'm wrong. We're going to fly around this a couple times. At least one or two of these buildings I think is super famous. But I'm not sure where it is. So we go across here. Is this still the academy? Yeah, this is the library. Or the cemetery, sorry. That's not the cemetery, but you get what I'm saying. There's a playing field. There's the grave of John S. McCain III, according to Google. It's down there somewhere. The actual cemetery, let's fly over the cemetery. That's not the cemetery. I think this is base housing. Like, these would be houses for people who live there, who work at the base or at the academy. It's not a base, it's an academy. It's a school. Okay, so the Sherman Forest Field, but the is that field, but the according to this, the cemetery is like right, it's on this little hill here. It's kind of like on a hill. But I think, wasn't it the chapel that's the really famous building? Might have to look this up. This down here, you can kind of see down here. Hard to tell, but there's little like white blocks down there. Maybe you can see them. Those represent, there's thousands of tombstones and graves down there. The three maintainers are part of the Naval Communications Station Washington transmitter. They're a relic of early 20th century radio. This is really interesting. Thank you. A vital part of the Navy's adoption. And what we're talking about here while I'm flying is we can see them from here, which way? Well, from this direction here. You can see that there, those three towers. That's where we kind of took off from. The towers provide a communication link between the U.S. and Europe, as well as between the Navy and the Atlantic Fleet. The towers were also a visual landmark. Interesting. Thank you for that research. Because, I mean, they look like something, but, you know, who knows what. Oops. Oh, wrong button. I'm just trying to see if one or more of these buildings looks, like, really iconic. I can land on the bridge. Well, that's true. I got to put my wheels out, but yeah. I mean, I was thinking of landing on water. But that's an interesting challenge. I don't think we can go under that bridge, right? Oh, wait a minute. Why can't we go under the bridge? I mean, I think there's room. And I'm the one that matters. Yeah, I might not be thinking of the right place in terms of iconic architecture, but it is a really interesting place. And you can see it, it's really cool looking. And all the buildings are kind of have this kind of retro futuristic look to them in a sense. All right. So did you land on the bridge? I could see land. You can land on just about any flat, straight surface. You know what? I don't know if this is one of those bridges you can go under. I think you can. I mean, I think it's possible. Oh, yeah. You could tell. You can go under that bridge, which we just did. Landing on the bridge, I don't know. Oh, let's go under this one, too, while we're at it. I mean, landing on the bridge is cool. I think going under the bridge is cool because that's something you could do in real life. You can't really land on a bridge, you know, and really expect to survive, you know, given traffic. Can we make it through these trestles? Let's find out. I mean, no, this is a tiny plane. There's tons of room. You'll see, it looks tiny, but then this plane gets really small as we approach. Plenty of room there. Hello? Power? Full power? Seems to be struggling to get more than 50 feet off the ground here. For some strange reason. We're fine. There's a freeway. So, yeah, I mean, you could easily land on a wide bridge. Any of these kind of wider bridges. But, hey, I'm in the Icon A5. I can land anywhere there's water. All right. So, we took a look at the... we took a quick look at the Naval Air Academy here, the Naval Academy, the United States Naval Academy, the original Naval Academy, by the way. But the city of Annapolis lies just to the southwest of it, and let's check it out. So again, this is part of it here. There's a field there, whatever that means. You can see a radio telescope over there in that corner, looking straight up. You can see here, that's the cemetery right there. A lot of famous naval people, John McCain, famous vice president and senator. All right, so Annapolis, where are you? It's got some other interesting looking buildings too. According to Google, this is basically Annapolis right here. I think that might be kind of Main Street, maybe. I don't know. It looks pretty. I wouldn't say it's, I mean, it looks, they did a good job. Oh, there's a stadium. Some kind, let's check that out. All right, so. What is this? This is the Navy Marine Corps Memorial Stadium. Hold on a second here. The Navy Marine Corps Memorial Stadium. Correct? Yes.
Okay.
The U.S. Naval Academy Stadium is also referred to. I think it's the same thing. And over here is there, that building there. That's the U.S. District Court. Okay. Well, I always like to check out the stadium, so that's good. And it's just the terrain. There's something about the terrain. It's, you know, there's a lot of water. Oh, I wonder if this is downtown Annapolis down there. I see some buildings. But just from the air, it looks nice. It looks gorgeous. As does a lot of America. Excuse me. And a lot of the world in general. I don't know what this is. But these are the only like reasonably tall buildings I've seen. Look at that. There's kind of a cool, like, hold on a second. I kind of want to check this out. No, we do. I'm just thinking this is some kind of modernist sculpture. There, kind of a modern. It either looks exactly like that or nothing like that. You know what I mean? Hard to tell. This is Whole Foods and Bed Bath & Beyond, all right? There's our plane. Let's get back in the plane. There's our Kenmore airplane there. And that's us. All right, so Whole Foods, Bed Bath & Beyond. Whole Foods Market. Doubletree Hilton Hotel by in Annapolis, is that it? I mean, that would make some sense. Eh, I think so, something like that anyway. That looks like these looks like hotels. And it is kind of, and there's like a Target there. Yeah, who knows? The Whole Foods is probably fine though. This is an extra large mall. It is technically called the that's not it. It's the Annapolis Mall, okay? So just, that is not a small mall. That is a big, and we saw the Mall of America, and it's bigger than this, but I can't imagine by much. This has got to be one of the biggest malls I've ever seen. This is an indoor mall, folks. It's got like 12 theaters and several like gigantic parking garages, but still, that's a big ass mall. But then it goes right into small town America, you know? Yeah, you're phasing in and out of reality. This is a great great view, though. A great level, you know, great. We're at just about 400 feet, and that's about the lowest you can go and still maintain the illusion of reality. And as soon as you see the roads and the small amount of traffic, then the reality tends to break down a little bit. But, you know, someday. Let's follow this out a little bit. I'm going to go past those towers and land, and that's going to be the stream for today. The flight simulator part. I do want to get to my piano part. As you know, when I play Piano Lounge, I like to mention this a few times per stream. I will be playing songs that I have memorized. I'm not looking at any notes or words. The only thing I have is a sheet that shows the titles of the songs. And if I didn't have that sheet, there's no way I'd remember what songs I have memorized. It's kind of weird, but you get the picture. So here's the this is the stadium. We'll fly over that again. We'll flow nice and low over the Marine Corps Stadium. You can see like a nice water tower over there. Yeah, they've done a lot of great detail work. Like all these houses look like they're real models, like of real houses. again, you get over here, and as soon as you get over on this side, the actual Naval Academy is right here, I think. Or is it that way? Yeah, it's down this way. Yeah, well, this is it here. This whole part is here. Is the Naval Academy too? So there's this section which has the library and probably a lot of other things. And this section down here. Yeah, your plane is just doing crazy things. Yeah, no. But that's what planes do. That looks like almost, I don't know, an auditorium? I don't know. But this sequence of buildings here is just really cool. And it reminds you kind of the Pentagon. Hello. Somebody's flying a jetliner around us. All right, we're going to land near, and again, we did, thanks, we did some research. We looked up what these towers were. They are related to the military, but they're very old. It's hard to tell, but they're like from the third, you know, from the early 20th century, apparently. Put some flaps down, slow the engines down a little bit here. You got to watch out. That's a water wall, I think, that you cannot land on. That'll stick. But once you get past it, we can land. Full flaps. I mean, they look like little Empire State Buildings. Or not, sorry, Eiffel Towers. That's what they get. You know what I mean. All right, water down, water rudder down so I can steer. Thank you. Flaps up so we don't take off again. It's a cute plane too. The icons are cute. It is a real plane. You could buy them, although I've heard that they don't manufacture too many of them or something. Or yeah. Well, I will be streaming tomorrow and Sunday as usual. I don't really have any particular plans to take off before my appointed Tuesday no stream day. And I'm looking forward to streaming tomorrow and Saturday and Sunday. I have absolutely no idea what I'm going to do. To turn off the engines. How do we turn off the engines? This way. Off. And there's a fuel, right? There's a fuel cut off back here. But it says close open, and then this is cabin lighting. That's messed up. You can't actually open. It has a big thing. This folds forward, I think. But in the game, I don't think it lets you actually open the door. I could be wrong on that. I thought, yeah, that's the parking brake. So I don't see anything that would open this door anywhere along the edges of it. Right there, that's not a door opener. No. Yeah, I think it just doesn't do. Did I fly all the Flying Fries planes? Did I fly all of them? Yes, I did. I mean, there's two. There's the... there's the sea, the monster and the sea monster, right? And then each one has three liveries, and I have flown all six of them. There were six, so there's two versions of planes and three liveries on each one. But the liveries are the same, right? There's a regular one, there's a red and a black and a different one. But I am going to fly them again. I'm a little worried until the next update comes out that they might cause my plane to crash, my sim to crash. But since that's happened, there has been some updates. There's been at least one client update. So I have a feeling maybe that's fixed. Anyway, we're an hour in, and that means that we've finished. We're going to take a little screen. Let me get a little sky here. There we go. We can see. Actually, maybe we can get these towers in the back. Oh, yeah. That's really impressive looking in a sense. Okay, there's a screenshot from today, like a little postcard I'm going to send to myself. I just did it, and I'm going to take, I did it, I am, we'll get around to them again. So I still want to fly the C-46, the C-47. We've got a lot of that glider is new. I've got so many new planes that I haven't really spent a lot of time with. So anyway, a couple minutes and I'm going to bring my piano out. I'm not even sure it's piano day, but I feel like playing piano. So I'm pretty sure it's piano day. So give me 3 minutes. It takes a little while for me to bring my piano out. Yeah, the glider was really fun. I want to do that some more. There's always opportunity. Yeah, you know, there's always opportunities to do it. The glider is a really different, fun experience. You know, going off the ground and then getting towed up, and then you pull your tow thing, and then you go down and you kind of land in a field, and it's really cool. I enjoyed that experience a lot. So maybe we'll do that tomorrow. But we'll do maybe I'll wait till Monday if you since you're back. It doesn't matter. Either way, you can watch on the VODs. Anyway, seriously, I'm gonna run my mid-roll. It's gonna take me literally 3 minutes to bring my piano out, and then I'm gonna just do all my songs that I have memorized. Because if I don't play them at least 3 times a week, I will no longer have them memorized. You know what I'm saying? Okay. All right, let's get this a little bit more. There we go. Like that. Trying to figure out what language that font is. It's obviously a right to left language, but I don't know. Somebody's the only person who has said anything so far in YouTube, well, I may have come and gone, has their name is in a foreign language, and I like to pride myself as somebody who can read foreign languages, at least know what the language is. And I'm really looking hard on this one. It looks like Tamil or Urdu, but I don't know for sure. Could be Thai. I don't think so, though. So yeah, so today we'll be playing my Lounge Act sound song list. And basically, all I've got here is a list of the titles of the songs and the author. But other than that, I don't refer to any musical notes at any time. And that's why I like to play these specific songs, because if I don't play them, I won't have them memorized anymore. Like this one, for example. Moving to the country, gonna eat a lot of peaches. Moving to the country, gonna eat me a lot of peaches. Moving to the country, gonna eat a lot of peaches. Moving to the country, gonna eat me a lot of peaches. Peaches come from a can. They were put there by a man in a factory downtown. Well, I'd eat peaches every day. Sun-soaking bulges in the shade. Moving to the country, gonna eat a lot of peaches. I'm moving to the country, gonna eat me a lot of peaches. Moving to the country, gonna eat a lot of peaches. Moving to the country, gonna eat me a lot of peaches. I took a nap where the roots all twist. I squished a rotten peach in my fist, and I dreamed about you, woman. I poked my finger down inside to make a little room for an ant to hide. Well, nature's candy in my hand, or can or pie. Peaches for me, millions of peaches, peaches for free, millions of peaches, peaches for free, peaches. Peaches by the Presidents of the United States of America. But you know, more mellow songs too. Yesterday I was watching my favorite guitar streamer, Tom, in Boston. I mean, today, not yesterday. Wonderful guitar player, Tom in Boston. Go to that guy. He does a great version of The Girl from Ipanema. It is my dream to do a duet of Girl from Ipanema. With him on the guitar, me on the piano. Anyway, welcome to Ken's Lounge. Hope you're enjoying your stay. We're just going to play some mellow piano tunage. Have a good time. Drink a lot of Diet Coke. It's too early in the day for me to be drinking actual alcohol, but later in the day. And if you're in a situation where you can enjoy a cocktail or beverage, I encourage you to do so. Learn that one a little bit more someday. That's fine enough. It's good enough. I can see clearly now the rain is gone. I can see all obstacles in my way. Gone are the dark clouds that had me blind, and it's gonna be a bright, bright, sunshiny day. Yes, I can make it now, the rain is gone. All of the bad feelings have disappeared. It's gonna be a bright sunshiny day. Look all around, there's nothing but blue skies. Look straight ahead, there's nothing but blue skies. Clearly now the rain is gone.
see all obstacles in my way. Gone are the dark clouds that had me blind, and it's gonna be a bright, bright, sunshiny day. And it's gonna be a bright, bright, sunshiny day.
All right. With some instrumentals, you know, little mellow instrumentals.
Thank you.
Welcome in. I hope you're enjoying the lounge. Got to play for another, 30 minutes or so. Some random songs from my lounge act that I have memorized. To some extent memorized. This is, if you can't play the song, you're not going to be a successful lounge pianist. This one. And then I like to do these lounge versions of Steely Dan songs. Why not? You're gonna stop me? Thank you. example. Peg. And then Josie. Suddenly Seymour from Little Shop of Horrors, one of my all-time favorite musicals. Great song, too, by the way. This song here is called Can You Read My Mind? It's called A Morning After. It's from the Poseidon Adventure. It was a big hit for Maureen McGovern in the late 70s. But I'm not going to sing it. It's from the movie The Poseidon Adventure. I think it was nominated for an Academy Award, but it didn't win. this is all my little theme. This is the whole section of mini section of songs within my lounge acts are all show tunes. So I played Suddenly Seymour from Little Shop of Horrors. This is A Morning After from The Poseidon Adventure. And the last one of this little set of show tunes is Can You Read My Mind from Superman the Movie. I liked it. I love all these songs, or I would not have gone to the trouble to memorize them. Of course, obviously. Obvious thing there. Most of the songs I sing are before the 2000s, but this song is from 1935.
Gee, it's great after staying out late, walking my baby back home. Arm and arm over meadow and farm, walking my baby back home. We go on harmonizing a song, or she's reciting a poem. Owls fly by and they give me the eye, walking my baby back home. We stop for a while, she gives me a smile and cuddles my cheek to her chest. We start to pet and that's when I get her powder all over my vest. After I kinda straighten my tie, she has to borrow my comb. Then it's one kiss, then we continue again, walking my baby back home. Straighten my tie, she has to borrow my comb. Well, there's one kiss, then we continue again, walking my baby back home. I'll be walking my baby back home. We'll be walking my baby back home.
Excuse me. And a couple more songs, why not? Do, 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 do. A couple more instrumentals, I would think. Tweet, take a look, give my voice a little rest. Like this one, always instrumental. And away, the fifth dimension.
All around me are familiar faces, worn down places, worn down faces, bright and early for the daily races, going nowhere, going nowhere. The tears are filling up their glasses, no expression, no expression. Hide my head, I want to drown my sorrow. No tomorrow, no tomorrow. And I find it kind of funny, I find it kind of sad. The dreams in which I'm dying are the best had. Find it hard to tell you, find it hard to take. When people run in circles, it's a very, very mad world. Mad world. Children waiting for the day they feel good. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Made to feel the way that every child should. Sit and listen, sit and listen. Went to school and I was very nervous. No one knew me, no one knew me. Hello teacher, tell me, what's my lesson? Looked right through me, looked right through me. And I find it kind of funny, find it kind of sad. The dreams in which I'm dying are the best I'd ever had. I find it hard to tell you, find it hard to take. People run in circles, it's a very, very mad world. Mad world.
That's an intense song, you know.
Heading up for San Francisco for the Labor Day weekend show. I got my hush puppies on. I guess I never was meant for glitter rock and roll. And honey, I didn't know that I'd be missing you so. Come Monday, it'll be alright. Want you back by my side. Well, it's been quite a summer. Met to cars and westbound trains. And now how you're off on vacation, something you tried to explain. Oh, honey, it's I love you so. That's the reason I just let you go. On Monday, it'll be alright. Come Monday, I'll be holding you tight. I spent four lonely days in a brown LA haze, and I just want you back by my side. I spent four lonely days in a brown LA haze, and I just want you back by my side. Well, it's been quite a summer, be flat. Beep, not much a sharp part of me now. Beep, major 7. Remember that night in Montana when we said there's no room for doubt. Hope you're enjoying the season. I know it's pretty up there. We can go hiking on Tuesday. With you, I'd walk anywhere. California has worn me quite thin. I just can't wait to see you again. Come Monday, it'll be all right. Come Monday, I'll be holding you tight. I spent four lonely days in a brown LA haze, and I just want you back by my side.
Oh, got that. You know, all these songs, I'm kind of on the edge of not remembering the chords. But, you know, most of them I kind of do. Oh man, I'm having a great time playing my little lounge act. By the way, if you guys are enjoying the show, I'll ask one thing, which is that you sidle up to the bar, that you order yourself a fancy cocktail, not a well drink or a beer or something like that. Not for me, for you. But most importantly, I got my Diet Coke here. You gotta tip the wait staff generously. They have on average 7 kids, and that's a lot of mouths to feed, you know what I'm saying? Stays a stranger, but with that the movie makes, well, another chance it takes. Odds are he won't live to see tomorrow. Beware of pretty faces you may find. A pretty face can hide an evil mind. What you say? Don't give yourself away. Odds are you won't live to see tomorrow. Well, secret agent man, secret agent man. When they're giving you a number and they've taken away your name, well, look out. Wait, I got it. Be sunning in the Riviera one day, and bleeding in a Bombay alley next day. Oh, don't care what you say, don't give yourself away. Odds are you won't live to see tomorrow. Well, secret agent man, secret agent man. Well, they're giving you a number and they're taking away. Well, look out, agent man, secret agent man. This mysterious life you live, it chooses a deadly game. One last song, which is basically Peanuts. Doesn't have words, because I can sing it. Oh, it's Let's try this from the beginning. What a show. Very similar to every other show I've done in that it's kind of mediocre. Which is great. You know what I mean? I'm totally happy with that. So thanks again. It's been about 2 hours, which is pretty much my endurance level. It's not going to increase, but I do try to do every day except for Tuesdays. So you'll see a very similar show tomorrow and the day after. Now tomorrow, the musical segment shall be Guitar Day. But other than that, it will definitely be a segment of Microsoft Flight Simulators. Again, we don't know where we're going to go. There's one city left, I think Southampton, New York, that's been on the list of the new cities that we have not visited. Other than that, I have no idea. If you want to come to the stream tomorrow, 11:30 PST, my general starting time on the weekends, go for about 2 hours. If you want to come and say, hey, we fly on my hometown, I'll probably do it. You know, it's been known to happen on repeated occasions. But I would like to give my little outro, which is to thank Carol Burnett. Who's Carol Burnett? I don't know. You can find out, because she's actually a lot of things to know. She's 92 years old. She's a Twitch partner. She's on all the time on Twitch. Her reruns from the 70s. She inspired me back in the 70s. I was a teenager. Lived at home with the family. We used to watch the Carol Burnett show together. And I didn't realize it, but it inspired me 40 years later to do my own variety show that's just like hers. I mean, we got comedy, we got musical segments, and we have audience interaction, just like her show. However, on her show, you'll get, and you'll see it in a minute because I'm a narrator. On her show, you get Tim Conway, you get Harvey Korman, you get Lyle Waggoner. And, of course, you get the incomparable Vicki Lawrence. And you get none of those people on my show, but you do get me doing this. So excuse me a second. Like on her show. Oh, hey, from Kenya. That's fantastic. Thank you. I'm glad. Hey, check out the VODs, by the way. This is the end of the show, but you can rewind and watch the whole show if you want. And I have hundreds of hours of this stuff. Very similar each time. Wonder how that works. But, you know, hey, I do flight simulator, I play the music. Anyway, I do my outro, which is like this. I'm so glad we had this time together, just to have a laugh or sing a song. Seems we just get started, and before you know it, comes the time we have to say so long. But I will see you tomorrow, and I'm going to rate Carol Burnett. So, you know, it's pretty typical. I'm going to watch the Carol Burnett the reruns over there. So come join me for a little while, okay? And I'm going to run my outro, and again, we'll see you tomorrow.